Hey Internet, Gordon Ung with PC World here. I am with Scott Stankard of AMD. You recognize him for a great video we had from Austin a few months ago. But we are here to talk about the star of tonight's news from AMD, which is this particular one. Internet, wait for it, 7950X3D. Yes, I know you've already seen the news. You finally get your 16-core Ryzen with X3D technology.
This video is sponsored by Silverstone, the leader in small form factor power supplies for over 10 years. The Extreme 850R Platinum is the world's first commercially available SFX 12V 4.0 power supply. This specification is the SFX equivalent to the latest ATX 3.0 spec and includes the PCIe Gen 5 12V high power connector and all of the great performance upgrades over previous gen power supplies. Pick up the Extreme 850R Platinum today and give your small form factor PC the power supply it deserves.
Scott is going to talk to us about it. I will go over the details. We have a Ryzen 9 7950X3D, Ryzen 9 7900X3D, and the Ryzen 7 7800X3D, which is the 8-core part. They have been long awaited because they've been talked about for a long time, but can we talk about the performance we're going to get out of these parts versus, say, older, the 5800X3D, Scott?
Yeah, certainly. So, you know, the difference, of course, between the 5800X3D and the 7800X3D is that upgrade to the Zen 4 core. So just like we saw great double-digit performance increases when we went from Ryzen 5000 to 7000, you're going to see the same thing when you go from the 5800X3D up to the 7800X3D. Of course, the Zen 4 core itself will provide great double-digit gaming performance, but also on non-gaming, just going to Zen 4, it's going to help out a lot there. Of course, these products specifically here versus the standard Ryzen 7000, you know, the X3D is really targeted towards gaming, and you're going to see some great gaming improvement there.
Yeah, I mean, look at this. So a Ryzen 7 7800X3D versus a 5800X3D, your older, much-beloved part, 21% in Rainbow Six Siege, 22% in Warhammer Dawn of War, and 23% in CSGO, 30% in Dota 2, so.
Yeah, the Zen 4 core is amazing. You know, it was amazing on the non-X3D, continues to be amazing here. Really glad that we can bring these X3D parts. I know everybody's been waiting on them. Glad that we can bring these parts to market.
So I want to ask you about some of the decisions that went into this X3D generation, because previously the thought was like, well, maybe it's not worth, why do it? It wasn't really worth it, it felt like, for a 16-core version. But this time, you're actually going to go with full 12, 16, and 8-core versions. What was the change from the previous version?
Yeah, that's right. So our first step into the X3D world was with the 5800X3D 8-cores. It showed that it had great gaming performance, still has great gaming performance. But you know, some of the feedback we had is, hey, what if I want all the gaming and I want all the cores? And what if I want all the frequency? And so what we were able to do with the 7000X3D parts is give all of that, right? Get the best of both worlds in terms of frequency, cores, and deliver the best gaming performance as well. And so what we've done with that is expand this to the two CCD products, and we've got the gaming, we've got the non-gaming, and yeah, I think we've given what people are really asking for here.
And, you know, I can't... We got to throw a little shot across Intel's bow here, but we do have a little bit of performance. Ryzen 9 7950X3D versus 13900K. Gaming, basically, more than double digits. Horizon Zero Dawn, 24%. Red Dead 2, 23%. Total War, Three Kingdoms, 18%. Rainbow Six Siege, 13%. So I was actually kind of like impressed, though, more, because this is the interesting thing about this choice with the 7950X3D part is you are offering a performance advantage over 13900K up to 50% in 7-Zip, DaVinci Resolve 24%, Premiere Pro 70%. I mean, I guess these two slides kind of tell you the secret is like you're getting better gaming performance and you're actually now getting also better, you know, multi-core performance, because that was 5800X3D was a great part, but you know, it definitely didn't have the core counts to go up against some of the competitor parts.
Sure. That was a trade-off that you had to make as somebody looking to make a purchasing decision on the old product, right? Was, you know, if I want the best gaming part, I want to go get the 5800X3D, but if I needed all the cores, then it didn't have all the cores. Well, here, you know, you can, you know, have your cake and eat it too. You've got all the cores. You've got 16 cores, but you've also got the X3D for the gaming. And so, Like we showed there, we show really strong gaming, you know, winning gaming, but then also having all that multi-threaded performance because we can do this on a 16-core product now. So it gives you everything that you could ask for, as well as the 1T boost frequencies of the 7950X3D and the 7900X3D match the non-X3D parts.
And that is actually the surprise to me, because the fact that again, look at the spec sheet, 5.7 gigahertz for the 7950X3D, yeah, which is the same as the 7950X, and the same thing for the 7900. How were you able to do this? Because I thought, you know, with the original 5800X3D, the clocks were held a little bit lower, but this one, you're getting the same boost clocks.
That's right. Yeah, I mean, the 5800X3D, I think at the time we said, hey, this is still sort of the early stages of the product, but we didn't want to hold it back and just like make it perfect before we got it out there. We wanted to get it in people's hands because we knew they'd love it, and they did. But our engineers have been hard at work the whole time trying to figure out how do we make, you know, two CCD versions of this without giving up anything. And so the way we approached it here was, as you know, we've got two different CCDs, as we call it, each of which has 8 cores. What we're doing here is one of those CCDs is what we've stacked with that extra 64 megabytes of L3 cache. That one is stacked. The other CCD is not stacked. And so what that allows us to do is when you're playing games, you've got all that cache available to you on one CCD. But if you're doing something more bursty, say, and you want all 5.7 gigahertz, you do that on the non-stacked. And we do that, and you know, you want to, I almost called it magic, but it's not magic, it's hard work, right, that we've done. And we've done it with within our engineering team, with Microsoft, with the gaming developers, such that we know which CCD to use at the right time. And now with that, you get your best 1T, you get your best gaming, and you get your NT out of all 16 cores.
Right, and you basically have games that need all that cache, they get the cache. It really is sort of best of both worlds in a way, because you get—
Absolutely.
Which it really did kind of shock me, because I expected the same setup where we just have duplicated, you know, both stacks. So it is kind of a cool approach. But I will say a lot of people will say like, well, gosh, why not give me that cache on both dies and I get even more performance? Scott, why not do that?
You know, in our own testing, we saw minimal benefit to putting it on both cores. Or on both CCDs, right? You know, most of those games, they're getting, you know, I'll call it the vast majority of the benefit by just having a single CCD stacked with all that cache.
Right.
They make use of that. Doing a second one didn't really, you know, benefit the gaming much. Certainly, it obviously would have added cost. And so the cost versus the benefit there just wasn't worth doing. And so this is the best way to do it. But then also by not stacking one of those CCDs, it let us push the 1T boost, the maximum 1T boost, up to 5.7 gigahertz. So we didn't have to compromise on 1T boost because we just stacked one in this asymmetric design, as we call it.
I was surprised to find this information out. So nice surprise. Let's see. Oh, the other question people want to know, can I overclock this? Because the original X3D wasn't the, you know, super fit for overclocking.
Great question. So we are doing a couple of new things with the 7000X3D we didn't have before. One, and the main one really, is curve optimizer. We did not have curve optimizer on the 5800X3D. We are enabling it now on the 7000X3D parts. And I think that's where you'll see a pretty good benefit, because it really plays into the power efficiency, keeping the voltage lower, pulling out some of the thermals, and being able to you know, I'll call it, you know, lean into the factory margins that we put into the part naturally, right? So just like Curve Optimizer works on non-X3D parts, but it works well with the physics of the X3D parts. So enabling Curve Optimizer was really the one big thing that we really wanted to do. Excuse me. Enabling that was big for us. We do also enable PBO now. We did not enable PBO before. Frankly, I don't think you'll get as much out of PBO, but Curve Optimizer, I think you'll see a nice little kick from. Still no, say, precise and direct, set the voltage whatever you want, sure, like you can do on non-X3D. You know, the X3D parts still are not intended to work that way, so we don't have that enabled today.
Right.
But I think, you know, giving you the best 1T boost on the non-stacked CCD part and enabling Curve Optimizer here, I think gives you a little room to play around with.
Okay, and the last couple questions that the accountants want to know is, when can I buy it? It makes accountants happy at AMD. When can I buy these chips?
Makes gamers happy too,
makes
right?
Makes gamers happy.
Yeah, so they'll be available in February. So right around the corner here, you know, we're putting the finishing touches on everything with our partners, and they'll be available in February.
Okay, and of course, the very last question, which I don't know, we're going to try to squeeze this out of Scott. How much are these parts going to cost?
We'll have to see on that. Can't talk about pricing quite yet, but we'll find out soon enough.
Okay, okay. Scott did good there. He passed the test. Not going to give away that secret information. But there you go. Those long-awaited X3D parts coming out. Got a lot of surprises in them. So stay tuned for more videos at PCWorld.com. And go to PCWorld.com for stories from CES 2022. And thank you for talking to me, Scott.
Thank you, Gordon.